I'm going to briefly discuss what an activity coefficient is and how it's used in solution thermodynamics. Important thing to remember is that we use activity coefficients almost always for liquid phases and not for gas phases. We also use them for solid phases. We'll mainly concentrate on liquid phases. The typical notation is gamma. So let me pause and write this down. So we use the notation gamma sub I for a given component. An important thing to remember, it's dimensionless. And essentially, the activity coefficient is to account for the fact that the solution is not ideal. An ideal solution, for example, if we have A and B that we mix together, then the interaction between A molecules and B molecules are the same as the interaction between A molecules and A molecules. In other words, there's no enthalpy of mixing for an ideal solution, right? So ideal solution means also that gamma I for each component is equal to 1. So we can have then deviations from ideal solutions, and we'll look at two types. They're normally related to the deviation from the Raoult's law plot for pressure. So the pressure above a mixture for an ideal solution, a binary solution, is the mole fraction, X1 is the mole fraction of liquid phase, times the saturation pressure for that component, plus the mole fraction for the second component and the saturation pressure. So this is from Raoult's law, which is for ideal liquid phase and ideal gas phase. So for a non-ideal system, then we add this correction factor, gamma. So for each component, there's a gamma that indicates how much it deviates from ideal. So if the pressure is greater than the ideal pressure, in other words, greater than the Raoult's law pressure, that would correspond to, and what we refer to as, a positive deviation from Raoult's law. And a positive deviation then corresponds to make the pressure, of course, greater than this pressure, means the gamma I's are greater than 1. And a positive deviation means the molecules don't want to be near each other. The pressure is higher because their tendency to escape into the gas phase. So the unlike molecules have weaker interactions. When I say they don't like to be near each other, the energy of bonding between A and B is less than between A and A, and or B and B. And so we have a higher pressure in the gas phase. If the difference is extreme enough, it would correspond to a case where we have an azeotrope. So let's look at a plot to make it a little easier to visualize this. So on the left, I plotted Raoult's law, where this equation is a straight line. The blue line, of course, then corresponds to this equation for pressure in terms of liquid phase mole fractions and saturation pressures. A positive deviation means that this line now is above the straight line. If it was sufficiently positive, as I mentioned, we could have an azeotrope. Well, then likewise, a negative deviation just means the line would be below the Raoult's law line. And so negative deviation means the gammas are less than 1. This means now that the A-B interactions are stronger than the AA or BB interaction. In other words, unlike molecules want to be near each other, they have less tendency to go into the gas phase. Well, let me just mention a couple other things about activity coefficient. The activity is the activity coefficient times the mole fraction of the component. So you can look at this almost like an effective mole fraction, the activity is. Again, the activity coefficient accounting for non-ideal. So when we look at fugacities, say fugacity in a solution, so the hat indicates solution in the liquid phase, it's the mole fraction in the liquid phase, the activity coefficient, and the pure component. So this is the pure component fugacity. And finally, let's look in terms of chemical potential Gibbs free energies. So the chemical potential for component I in solution is equal to its pure component chemical potential, the gas constant, absolute temperature, and then the log of activity coefficient times the mole fraction. Of course, this is the log of the activity. So important, this is the pure component, and this is this component in solution. Okay, so remember the chemical potential is a Gibbs free energy, and this is the partial molar Gibbs free energy, and other screencasts discuss partial molar properties. The final equation relates the activity coefficient for a component to the excess partial molar quantity over RT. Again, excess means results because of deviation from ideal. So remember, the activity coefficient is going to be 1 if we have an ideal solution, or as Xi approaches 1, gamma I is going to approach 1. Now, other screencasts where we'll discuss other aspects of solution, but understanding what activity coefficient is and then how we use it is important for phase equilibrium for 9 ideals liquids.